Next, we'll look at refraction using a different printout, the refraction one that has the pluses and the minuses, and the acrylic lens. You're going to want to line the acrylic lens up with its outline, turn on your laser, and when you just come in on the dotted line on one side, you should, if everything is lined up, continue on the dotted line on the other side, straight out the other side, and then making sure that you still strike that place where the dotted line exactly matches the face, you're going to take a series of measurements of the incident angle and the leaving angle. And so you'll want to mark points. For instance, you could mark this as A incident and this is A refracted, and then at a different point, B incident and B refracted, and do it on both sides of the normal, C incident, C refracted. You need about 11 data points. Let everyone in the group take a few, and in every case, you should have pairs of points. Now, once you have those points, you actually are interested in the sine of the angle to look at Snell's law, and the easiest way to do that is actually just measure the height from the horizontal. So 3.22 centimeters on that side and 5.15 centimeters on that side for a matching set of points. Get all 11 measurements and compile a table, and you'll use that to calculate the index of refraction of your disk. Now, the quadrants are labeled positive and positive, negative and negative. Measure these heights as positive and then these heights as positive, these heights as negative, and the corresponding pairs' heights on the other side as negative.